Iron Chef spicy shrimp cocktail. So, 2 bay leaves, water, no salt, none, zero, peppercorns. End of story.
Bold!
Right here, I have my shrimp. They're U16, U12, U11, it's per pound. So if U16 are slightly smaller, U8s are jumbos, big ones. Anything too big, it becomes like a first course entree. It's chewy, it's too much shrimp at one time.
Yeah.
This is something you should dip with the tail into the sauce, eat it, throw this tail away, and go back for more right away.
So just to clarify, U12 means a pound is under 12 pieces.
Yes.
Is a pound in weight, which is a medium size. So a U8, under 8, is bigger.
Giant.
As the numbers get smaller, the shrimp gets bigger.
U1's a lobster.
Are you ready? Ketchup. Do you use ketchup when you're making this?
Love.
Okay.
What else would you use?
Well, there's other chili sauce and stuff like that.
No.
I use ketchup.
That's the best.
Okay.
The shinier, the better.
Yeah. Horseradish, like so much, it's ridiculous.
Geoffrey, that is a lot of horseradish.
Okay, be careful.
Hot sauce?
Who are you?
A little bit of chili.
Oh, a little chili.
Sweet chili glaze, yeah.
Chili glaze, wow.
Lemon juice.
Whoa.
Worcestershire sauce.
There it is, from the hometown.
I can't with the sweet chili sauce. That really surprised me, I love that.
So it should not appear red, it should appear almost like that. You see that? We're gonna let that sit and hang out. Now, our shrimp are going in.
Uh-oh.
Right here. I let that cook just for a little bit just to get some of that. It's changed color. The peppercorn has changed color of the water. In boiling water. And now what we're gonna do is the most important thing. I don't keep my shrimp on ice. I don't put my shrimp in an ice bath after because guess what they soak up? Water.
Water.
And I put them in the fridge after I cook them on this right away.
No shocking.
No shocking whatsoever because it's another step. It's another waste of water and waste of time and a dish you gotta prepare. It shouldn't be hard to do this. This shrimp was thawed in the fridge overnight. I bought it peeled, cleaned, ready to go, frozen.
Wow.
Okay, you don't have to buy fresh shrimp for this. So now we're just gonna mend and we're gonna take our time and look at this, you see?
What
right away, they're
doing?
Always starting to curl a bit. So if you can see right now, they're starting to get white and translucent. This is gonna take not a lot of time, but you must cook them fully. I would err on the side of, of slightly overcooking them. If you're gonna go this route, be careful, you don't wanna undercook them.
Somebody write undercooked down shrimp. The
nose heat is getting to his brain, I think.
Yeah,
when you cut a shrimp in half that's cooked, it should be white the whole time.
You're moving them around a lot as you cook. Why are you doing that?
Just because they'll cook evenly. This is just a little method. I don't have a lot of water, I don't have this big pot of water.
It's not
these
a boil.
Go right on a paper towel.
You did it.
They're fully cooked. I'm gonna let you just take a smell of that. And you tell me what you smell. Just pass it down.
Just shrimp.
Okay, you don't smell lemon.
You don't smell 5,000 exotic, weird.
It smells like shrimp cocktail. The good
old-fashioned shrimp cocktail. In the fridge, just like this, uncovered. In 5 minutes, it cools down, you're ready to serve it. That's it.
Can you blast chill it in the freezer?
No, you don't have to do
frisky?
That. Don't waste your time.
All right.
Put some more Sinatra on, make another martini.
There you go.
Okay.
That sounds delicious. A dirty martini and a shrimp cocktail?
Oh, nothing like it. Now, I don't put these on ice when I serve them, shock them, or store them. They're always off ice. You put these out in small quantities, not large quantities, so they get eaten, then you take out more small quantities and fill up. You don't put like a whole stuff on ice. I hate them when they're on ice, because invariably you get a piece of ice and you're eating ice.
I hate that.
Okay, you ready? Here's our beautiful spicy sauce. This should destroy my nose. And that's where I like it to be at.
Wow, very aggressive approach.
Geoffrey.
I think your septum's gonna melt.
Here we go.
Ooh.
Ready?
Oh my
Stage
God.
Five clinger.
My mouth is watering.
It is. Snappy. Snappy the shrimp. Uh-oh.
Good, you saw the horseradish. It's not too much. The sweet chili sauce actually tames it down. The long range effect of this is you want more, and that's what a shrimp cocktail should want you to make. And this is so delicious. This sauce I just made for you, you can make a big batch of it. It's one of these things that lasts, actually gets better. And this is so simple, there's no reason to ever make this and overcook it again.